You are now listening to the Salty Virgins Podcast.
Welcome to the Salty Virgins Club Podcast. I am your host, Jordan. I'm here with Kevin and Patrick. Jackson is celebrating Casey's birthday.
Happy birthday, Casey.
Yay. Happy birthday, Casey.
Happy Patrick to it.
We said it at the same time, you bitch.
I heard it from my mouth first, so I don't know. We'll go to the tape later.
Run it back.
Christine will let us know.
Yeah, she's...
Maybe Poppy
will. She's in fucking Alaska. Who knows?
Everywhere she goes, a different part of her body blows up with swelling.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Christine lives the coolest and also most inconvenient and unfortunate life simultaneously at the same time.
Mm-hmm. She's been all over the world and has gotten sick in every place.
When we are in Costa Rica. She scratched her cornea. Or is Thailand? Costa Rica? One of the two. She scratched her cornea.
Yeah, you went to both.
She scratched her cornea, but not from, like, something happening and something scratching her cornea, but just from, like, her pair of contacts. She just left it in her eyes for too long, and a piece of debris got in there, and then, like, scratched her cornea. Like, I've never fucking heard of that happening to someone.
That's a tough thing.
You know what
scratch.
A great time for that to happen is? In a foreign country.
Yeah. Where you don't speak the language.
It was Costa Rica.
Insurance is cheaper.
Well, when you need to bring the optometrist in because it's midnight and you have a searing pain in your eye and he has to be on call to come into the hospital. Yeah, different. I got the convenient.
Damn,
oh,
it cost $40.
$13 for. No, she had to bring in a fucking surge in the only, like, the biggest city in Costa Rica. That was a tough scene. Tough scene for the girl. And then she had to wear an eye patch the next couple days, which made for some fantastic pictures.
It's pretty.
I actually have some. I'll show you guys.
That's what Emma's mom does, is like almost trauma, like eye surgery.
Yeah. It was like, I think no surgery or anything, but they needed like the run of the mill, like ER doctors were not like going to be.
It's a very specialized. The eye is
specialized. Yeah. It's one of those things where everyone's like, oh, no, I don't want to. Can you imagine just being, like, a general practice doctor? Someone's like, I need you to help me with my eye. You're like, nuh-uh.
No. Yeah.
No fucking
you certainly
chance,
don't want that.
That's the shit you see with.
You want to keep that? You don't want me to do that. It's like your eyes and your teeth are the two that you don't want just, like, regular doctors dealing with.
I would say your teeth are easier to work on than eye.
Oh, eye's much harder. But, yeah, I understand your premise.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, no, eye is like, yeah, that's
it's
tough.
Very specialized, yeah.
I would say any orifice in your body, you should have a specialty doctor.
Yeah, I mean, well, ER doctors handle a lot more ass stuff than you think.
I was going to say, ass and nose are like the secondary orifice when it comes to necessary doctors.
Yeah, and ER doctors do a lot of stuff.
Eye
with
and
those.
Mouth are top tier. Ass, I mean, I understand if you... But really, if you're going to, like, a specialist for your ass orifice, it's more of, like, internal.
Yeah.
It's not like, external. You know, if you got fucking hemorrhoids, you just go to any fucking doctor. You're like, here's a donut.
You don't need to go to fucking a doctor for hemorrhoids.
Here's a donut.
It's a preparation H.
Eat it, fatty.
But the problem is when you have hemorrhoids for the first time, you're just going to be like, you know what? I have hemorrhoids. I've seen this before on a house, and I have hemorrhoids.
Me and my asshole intimately acquainted. I know what's happening.
I would have a strong suspicion that I have hemorrhoids, but I'd probably get that shit checked out.
I think it's pretty obvious if you have hemorrhoids.
Once again, I think the first time, you probably go to a doctor. After that, you're sure. This is just hemorrhoids again.
Again?
My insides are on the outside.
I need more broccoli in my diet, is what that is.
But hemorrhoid doesn't have to be because of, like, a diet thing, right? Like, if you just, like, strain too hard in general, can't you just...
You pop your colon
yeah,
out.
Yeah, you pop your asshole out, but...
Is it only from shitting? I don't know. Not a medical doctor. This
no,
is
I
not
think
financial
if you, like, strain yourself, like, lifting something, you can get a hemorrhoid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I was more getting at. I knew who's part lifting. Of your inside came outside on a hemorrhoid. I didn't know the... What was where.
Yeah, it's like a ridge of your asshole pops out.
Ah, welcome to the Salty Virgins Club podcast. This is the start of the podcast. We have not been talking since then, and here's the beginning.
I have a non-ass related topic.
What? No.
Oh, come on.
Did you see the Tour de France person run into the girl with the sign?
You said non-ass related, because that is a dumb ass.
Fair enough.
This bitch wanted her sign on TV so bad that she wrecked the entire Tour de France Peloton.
Just the whole thing. She
the Peloton.
On day one.
Yeah. Day one, leg one.
That's a tough stage.
They're trying to sue
everybody
her.
Was piled up. Imagine well, they should!
Getting sued by the Tour de France.
She, listen, they gotta, like, really get some money. Well, I don't know if they're gonna get out of her, but out of somebody for that. Because she ruined a whole sporting event.
Also, just think about, like, the Tour de France, whatever puts that on, they got the money. But the cyclists in the Tour de France, if you're not, like, a top 10 cyclist...
Name one cyclist that's not Lance Armstrong right now.
Go and do
it. That's not the point that I'm making. I'm not saying they're not famous, because they're not famous. But from a money perspective, like you have sponsors and shit, but they're not paying you to run year round, right?
No.
Run. Wow, they're not even running.
Cycle.
Let's look at top earning cyclists. What this maybe the first time this ever been Googled.
Kevin makes more money than
me. I'll say 2019, because 2020 was a weird year, if you know what I'm saying.
There was a pandemic and people died, yes.
The number one ranked cyclist in the world is Primoz Roglic.
That sounds like a cyclist name.
So, the top 15 made above... I'm trying to find what that threshold is. So, the top 15 made above $1 million in the year.
Together?
But, No. Like, because they have, like, they ride on, like, regular tours and they have sponsors, but only, like, the top teams pay, like, a lot of money. Because, like, in Europe, cycling is, it's not, like, a huge deal, but it's a much bigger deal than it is in the fucking States. Like, people care about it. People go there and hold signs, you see?
Yeah. Well, I mean, fair.
But I know there's, like, there's a drop-off where, like, if you're up within this threshold, like with most sports, but it's just, like, smaller than... You know, and like golf, it's like if you're on the PGA Tour for more than like 2 years, you probably got it like that. In the NBA, it's like if you're in the NBA, you got it like that. If you're not, that fucking sucks, bro. But you can even be in Europe and make like good money.
Decent money, yeah.
Or you could make a shit ton of money in the NBA, and then when you can't make any more money in the NBA, go make a shit ton of money in Europe or China.
Or you could be Nikola Mirotic and just be like, I don't want to be here anymore, and go back to
home. He was like, I've been playing for about 4 years. I've banked about 22 mil. I'm going back to fucking Europe, bro. This place stinks.
Bobby Portis hates me, and I have to play with him all the time? No.
That man got punched in the face so hard that his orbital bone was broken, and then they cut him.
Him.
Not the guy that
punched
him.
It wasn't his orbital.
His orbital?
No, it was this bone right here, like above your mouth. Yes. Above your mouth. I'm talking to you, visual medium. The bone above your mouth, it's the maxo something. Cause
I don't even care. Like, yeah. So he just got punched in the mouth. Like, not even in the
mouth. He got his top jaw broken. His top jaw broken.
Imagine getting your jaw broken by a teammate, and then you get cut from the... And at this point, he was, like, getting good fucking minutes. He might have been starting.
He was good! Like,
he got punched in the... You know he had to have said some... Vile shit, though.
Oh, yeah.
You know
it
he Myers
insane.
Learns that shit. Like, oh, he cocked back and something came out of his mouth that everyone was like...
Maxilla.
Everyone was like, you know what? I know your face hurts, but also your key card don't work no more, dude.
Like, but also, cut.
Imagine the GM that like has to cut Bobby Portis, the man that just broke someone's mouth bone.
Yeah, no, Bobby Portis is from Arkansas. He's from a place in Arkansas that can't go back, so...
He will certainly fight about it.
As presented, Nikola Mirotic.
That was one of those things before that happened, because this happened for reference, if anyone doesn't know, like, what, 3-4 years ago?
Something like that.
When, like, that started a discourse on Twitter about, like, places to be from where you certifiably can fight. And Arkansas was, like, by and large, the number one fucking answer. Like, certain areas in Arkansas, I don't know, but, like... I was expecting, I don't know, big city, like, toughest neighbor. No, everyone's like, no, Arkansas. They have nothing to do but fight. Like, this is
fight
like,
and drink.
It was just a consensus.
Yeah.
Like, Arkansas, if you grew up in Arkansas, not a good place. You probably grew up poor, and you probably grew up fighting about it. Mm-hmm. I was like, that's, you know what? Tough scene.
And Youngstown, Ohio.
Yeah.
They do a lot of fighting there. A lot of fighting.
It's free entertainment.
Yeah. It's that. Talk about got it off the mud.
Yeah, it's a tough scene.
Yeah.
But I would have, if you had asked me 5 years ago, like, top 20 states that people know how to fight, Arkansas would have been, because I was thinking, Arkansas, they got guns. They don't fight, they got guns.
No.
They just shoot each other. Wildly irresponsibly. No, they actually have hands as well.
These hands still work.
Yeah, no. I'd never fight someone with a razorback hat on.
No.
Also, don't talk to people with razorback hats on. Like, what?
They're terrible people.
Find better friends.
Yeah. No. Arkansas is one of the states without a dot, as Bomani Jones likes to say.
You said without a what? Without a dot? There's not a single pin.
Nope.
Snap Maps pretends it doesn't exist.
Is he hot as well spots not
on Snap Maps? He's like, no, never. Arkansas, never heard of her.
Yeah. No.
Cold.
Is it, is it really cold in Arkansas? I thought it was like as cold as Georgia, right?
Yeah, it's
well, no, probably a little colder. Level. Maybe like as cold as like the Virginias. Where is it?
It's just above Louisiana.
Longitudinally. Is that a word?
Longitudinally, I think it's the word.
That sounds a lot better. Longitudinally sounds like a...
like you're a child like trying to figure wiggle. It out.
Yeah. Like...
It's in line with like Tennessee and stuff.
Okay.
But yeah, I was referring to the Snap Map. Yeah, there's not a single event happening.
That makes a lot more sense. I mean, I'm not the fastest right now. I may be more coherent than Caleb, but...
Sure.
That's not funny to anybody but you two, exactly. So...
I think Little Rock is the only town I've ever heard of.
And the fact that Little Rock has been heard of is a travesty.
Yeah.
It's a town named after a small rock.
Is it the biggest?
Are you about to ask me a question about Arkansas?
It's the capital.
Sure.
Little Rock tops. Wow. Come on, Kev. Figure it out. Arkansas top cities.
Why?
Google should just spit that back.
Little Rock has a whopping population of 200,000, and it's the biggest city and, fun fact, the only city that has a 6-digit population in Arkansas.
That tracks.
I've heard of
that
Fayetteville has 85,000 people.
That's
90,000 in the 2021 census. 90,000 people.
Colleges, right? Fayetteville.
I thought it was in Little Rock, to be honest. No fucking clue.
Yeah, it's Fayetteville. That's why I've heard of it.
This is a lot of Arkansas talk.
I had something else stupid about Arkansas that I was going to Google. Oh, I was going to Google things to do in Arkansas.
No?
Things to do in Arkansas. Okay, they have some hot spots.
Fight.
There's like...
Flee.
State parks and then some museums. That's about what I expected.
Yeah, that about tracks.
This museum looks kind of fire. The William J. Clinton... Wait.
Oh, yeah, called? Bill Clinton's from... Yeah, Clinton's from there.
Oh, well, that's how you know.
Well, his name is William Clinton. You know.
No, I know. I saw William J. Clinton. I read it, and then I was like... I assumed Bill Clinton when I read it, and then I was like, why would they list it as William? Like, that man's just fucking Bill. That man is not fucking William. He's just Bill.
I agree.
You look at that, that's Bill.
I agree.
That's how, like, George Bush is fucking George, and his brother Jeb, or cousin... Anyway.
That's his brother.
Like, those names fit the fucking person so perfectly.
Jeb.
Was that guy? Obadiah. Jeb? Oh, yeah, no, that makes sense. That guy looks like a Jeb.
Yeah.
That is a cool-looking museum, though.
Palm Bay would be the second largest town in Arkansas.
That's catastrophic levels of bad. Oh, my God.
Arkansas is down tremendously. Like I said, a state without a dot.
The 19th largest city in Florida. Top 20, sure. Baby. We're in there.
Sure.
I live in Arkansas right now.
Listen, six in one hand.
There's probably less fighting in Palm Bay than there is Arkansas, yeah?
I wouldn't go that far. Palm Bay, they might do a lot of fighting.
Much more mayoral swindling.
Yes.
You think they're not swindling in Arkansas?
They're
Republicans, and they make like $12 a year.
You're right. Well, on the books.
On or off! off! It's Arkansas! They don't even have an airport!
Wait, no, they have an airport.
They have to have it. That can't be true.
I don't know. If they didn't have an airport, would you be surprised?
Arkansas's biggest airport is Bill and Hillary Clinton National Airport. The abbreviation, first of all, fire. It's lit.
L-I-T. Okay, that's pretty good. That's pretty good.
I can't believe they didn't put a C in front of that.
And then, okay, so secondary fire. Northwest Arkansas National Airport is the second biggest airport in Arkansas, and the abbreviation is XNA. So close to Xanax.
What?
It adds up.
No, it doesn't.
It sure doesn't. Well, I mean, they probably are hit by the opioid epidemic.
What is ENPL? Does anybody know that acronym off the top of their head?
No.
Oh, emplanements. The number of emplanements that occurred at the airport in the calendar year. So the biggest airport in Arkansas didn't even crack 1 million planes in a calendar year.
Case in point.
What do we think LAX's emplanement rate is?
Million.
100 million, maybe?
LAX emplanement 2019.
We're doing a deep dive on some bullshit right now.
In 2019, LAX saw 88 million planes.
Woo-wee!
And in 2020... they still saw 29 million.
That's nuts.
Listen, people were still going to LA.
Orlando only saw 24 million.
In 2020?
No, in 2016.
Oof. It seems like there's always so many people.
Yeah.
Listen, there's aviation statistics out the wazoo here. This is great.
A lot of...
we're looking at advanced metrics for planes right
I'm
now.
I'm all in this pitch. I'm about to see the fucking war of the Jacksonville International Airport. It's going to be sick.
I need to know their ERA.
We have to talk about something different. We're too deep. We're too deep.
Tyler, the creator, dropped an album. It was very good.
For reference, Jacksonville International Airport saw 7 million emplanements in 2018.
And that's not even a good airport.
That's a relatively small airport. It's 7 times bigger than the biggest airport in Arkansas. So fuck you, Arkansas. But also don't fuck you, because I don't want to fight about it.
Yeah, no. It's still fuck you,
Sounds
Arkansas,
like you do.
Yeah, I'll be waiting outside my house in 3 days.
Hey, what you say about me, pussy?
I traveled 28 hours to get here. I had to take 4 fucking connections.
Derek McFadden was robbed.
The only Arkansas player you could think of, huh?
Yep. They got Ryan Mallett, right? Ryan Mallett? Didn't he get caught up with drugs? He got caught up with drugs.
I'm sure he did.
Anyway.
He lives in Arkansas.
Yeah. No, I agree. Tyler, the Creator's album came out. It was very good. I recommend everybody listen to it.
I have not listened, but it's on my list. I'm just a lazy ass.
He also added
it on Spotify.
I'm adding it right now.
Wilshire, I think it's like the 12th song on the album, he raps for 8 minutes about how he tried to fuck his friend's girlfriend.
That sounds like the kind of thing that I want to listen to twice. It's going to be so funny, but then it's just not going to be like a song that I can listen to.
Yeah, no, it's fine.
Yeah.
But it was insane that he just put that much nastiness into the world and was like, this is good. This is what you need on this otherwise perfect album.
Listen, credit to him. He was kind of right. Have you seen the world?
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
Yeah,
but like...
I bet that resonated with a lot of Tyler, the Creator listeners.
It resonated with me.
Case in point.
I was like, I see where you're coming from. Yes, me, a stan, really.
Have you watched the Bo Burnham special?
I still haven't.
It is very good. Very, very depressing. But good.
Yeah, no, I love recreational sadness. It's my favorite thing.
Yeah, you have to be in the right mental place. I mean, I'm a Bo Burnham stan, so it's just, I'm listening to the album all the time.
I have to be in a right mental state?
I get that for sure.
I can't stop listening to the songs. They're so catchy.
It's a good point, Jordan. Good mental states don't really exist anymore. But the thing is, it's the kind of humor that can really make you sad, but also is the exact kind of humor that we just fucking hang our hats on,
yeah,
just
really
done way
is.
Better. Like, way better. It's true.
From the podcast that jokes about killing themselves 8 times an episode, it's really right in there. Like,
listen, these aren't jokes.
Again,
these aren't jokes. Are his... These are jokes. These are jokes.
Are they?
Mostly.
Yeah. Yeah.
I didn't just spend so much money on a dog knee to kill myself.
They all start as jokes. It's one of those things.
Yeah, I mean,
it's like a seed.
Life imitates art, you know.
No, but very sure. Good. I recommend everyone go watch it.
If it's called Inside.
Yep.
Yeah, the songs are great. Kayla had a friend listen to it, or Katie. You guys know Katie as well. But she had her listen to it today or this weekend or something. But she had her just like listen to the songs, a couple of the songs, but she hadn't seen the special. And the songs are, like, good and catchy, but it's one of those things where, like, you need to hear and see it because it's, like, it's done really, really well. So I'd recommend, like, actually watching the special, and then the songs are fire after that. But also, you're going to want to kill yourself a little bit. I mean, to me, like
I said. A little bit?
Preaching to the choir, baby.
A little bit.
So, but yeah, it was good. I played soccer today for the first time in, like, competitively in, like, upwards of a year. Mm-hmm. And y'all want to guess what time my soccer game was today? A Sunday in June in Florida?
Know. 1 p.m.
3 p.m.
Oh, God.
If you look at the graph of the temperature spikes and the hottest point of the day, it'll probably be sometime between 2 and 3 p.m. I showed up to the field. It was raining. I was like, this is sick.
Sub.
Please keep raining. Y'all want to know when the fucking rain started?
Right. Stop. When the game.
Sorry. 2:57 p.m.
Oh, no.
So the field was all nice and baked for you when you stepped on.
I forgot to mention, it was a turf field.
Oh, God.
I just
get back in my car.
I was in the adult league, right? So the second half was basically like everybody standing, and then every once in a while someone feeling real inspired and making a run, and then hating themselves for it. Yeah, I was joking with some of the people on the team, but also this is completely true, is I have not been that hot since literally high school. When I was playing sports in that heat in high school, I was also running 4 to 5 miles a day. Very yeah. different versions of Kevin. Like, exponentially different versions of Kevin.
Some of the shit, like, Trill talked about it, but some of the shit we just, like, put up with in high school is insane.
The whole conversation about having gym class first fucking period and then eating lunch at 10:30 a.m.
It's like, no wonder niggas was mad. You're eating square pizza at 11:30.
And then a lot of kids were doing, like, activities and shit to, like, 6, so that fucking pizza was what you got.
Yeah, it was like, you better love this square pizza, because, like, you got baseball or softball or track or whatever after school. Good luck.
And then if that pepperoni bread didn't last you the whole day, that was it. Sorry.
You just angry.
Also, the concept of, like, I've always been a really sweaty person. But in high school, it was one of those things where it's like, you didn't want it to happen, but it was kind of whatever. But as an adult looking back, and if my child in so however many years comes home and tells me, yeah, no, I have to have my gym clothes on at 7:30. And then I have to take them off and don't have time to shower because they provide showers, but not time to shower. And then I have to wear normal clothes on top of my sweaty body for 7 to 8 hours.
Yeah.
With all of, like, my friends who are so mean.
Niggas was going to volleyball, like, class and then calculus. Like, that's nasty.
Why aren't you
that's
concentrating? Disgusting. I'm still sweating.
I'm hot.
The gym didn't have AC today.
Remember when our school used to just, like, not have AC for days?
They just had big fucking fans.
And they're like, hey, that's fine. I remember somebody I was talking to, they were like, yeah, when the school doesn't have AC, my mom just checks me out. Like, that's unacceptable. Like, she says you can't learn in this way.
I agree. Like,
listen, she was right. I'm just sitting in fucking physics, just like a dog, because our school was outside and in Florida.
If I am ever in a place where the AC in my home is broken and I don't take a sick day, I want one of you two to personally shoot me dead like a horse. Take me out to pasture and shoot me dead.
I'd put you on a plane to get to my house to have AC than let you just be in your house with no AC.
We all know I would never do that, but like if I was ever, like the thought of that is like, oh no, AC's out today, but you're still going to learn all of this shit that you didn't want to learn in the first place.
Absolutely not.
Kara. And then the teacher, they're paying the teachers shit. They're like, no, you guys have to teach these kids that also don't want to learn this.
Just as angry as you are. So Kara has a friend in Portland right now whose AC just went out. I don't know if you've seen the
weather. It's like 118 degrees out there. Yeah. They may not live. It's 111. Kara may not have a friend anymore.
She bought one of the, actually the same AC unit I have back here. It's not doing shit. Not for 111.
Yeah, I think at that point you just have to leave.
They had to postpone the Olympic meets. I think they have them in Portland because the track was 150 degrees.
Unacceptable. I'm surprised they didn't make them fucking run in it.
Do you think they're actually going to have the Olympics?
Yes.
100%.
How bad is the fallout from the Olympics going to be?
When you say fallout, what do you mean? Because if you mean the
COVID.
Oh, okay. Because I thought if you meant like coverage and like perception, because no, everyone's going to crown it as a success. Yeah. How bad are like the fallout when it comes to like injuries and sicknesses,
COVID and things and, like that.
Oh, gonna be terrible.
Okay. Because like,
I hope it's not.
I hope for the best for those athletes, especially the female athletes. Shout out to female athletes. Everybody seems to be doing just wonderful things. Shakari Richardson.
Yeah.
We're getting a lot of female, like, not just runners, but like female athletes coverage. And I like that. That's good. I guess the men just aren't good this year, which is fine.
which
yeah, that's fine. But though,
I think the men are still pretty good. I don't think there's been.
I haven't seen a single thing about a male athlete.
I think there's been a dramatic shift in coverage of men and female sports in general, and that like there's been more of a push over the past couple years to get more coverage. Because remember, like growing up, the WNBA, it was like the WNBA were like, oh no, thank you, that shit stinks. And to be fair, the WNBA at that time had some ballers, but yes. Also the games were not as nearly as entertaining. Like the women they have right now playing basketball are fucking hooping. And there's
shout
also
out Elizabeth Kembage. I would like you to step right on my head. Thank you.
There's been more of a push for that. And then like, also there's just been like people, there's been a more,
concerted
effort to like try and get more coverage to women's sports. And I also just think that like, it makes me wonder, 20, 30 years ago, were people doing this cool of shit always and we just didn't hear about it? You know what I mean? Were like people being this cool and being good, or were they just being stuck? You know what I mean? Because now there's more avenues to express yourself and be out there and connect to people. So I wonder if people, like, if we've just kind of been missing.
I think the Olympic runners have kind of always been pretty cool because there was Lolo Jones and that group.
Yeah, that's fair.
That was about 40 years ago now. But, like, they were always pretty cool. Now, I can't say across the board was everybody cool, because who fucking knows, you know, the hopscotch champion or whatever. I don't know. But, like, most of the black runners were pretty cool. I mean, in the 40s, they had the social justice movement, like, thing.
Oh, that made them very uncool to a lot of people.
Yeah, I don't care about
one,
those people.
One person in particular.
Yes, Hitler. The person was Hitler. that I don't really care about. But I think they were always pretty cool. Generally,
I have those thoughts specifically about athletes being cool, but just in general, like with something that I feel like I see happen a lot today, good or bad, generally bad. It's not generally the good side of things. It's generally like, was the world always this bad? And the answer is yes, it was, but it just wasn't as in your face or covered.
Yeah.
Which is also good and bad. The bad is real fucking terrible, though.
And that's why we're fighting about critical race theory, which is just U.S. history.
Oh, I did log in to LinkedIn today, and
oh no,
there was like DeSantis said something, rise but basically like in Florida schools now he's trying to make it required for schools to teach the quote evils of communism.
Yeah,
and there was a lot of comments about like great for DeSantis, you know, because Republicans love DeSantis, you know, because they're bad people, but yes. And my thought the whole time is like, anytime something bad happens in the U.S., fucking white, and this is not my original content. This is a tweet that I, so you guys know, but every time something bad happens in the US, everyone's like, this is just like China. It's like, no, this is kind of like the US. And yeah. One thing that people harp on China a lot is for like propaganda. Well, they don't consider that propaganda, whatever, but also like forcing you, communism is so bad because they make you love it. Well, what the fuck are we doing?
What about my bootstraps, sir? What about my bootstraps?
Communism is bad because it teaches you to hate capitalism. But capitalism is good because it teaches you to hate communism. I'm not saying either one is better or worse. But when we're looking at, it feels like an uneven playing field here.
Well, so the reason all of this works is because people don't know history. Like, if you just, like, looked at history, I think I said this last week, but if you just looked at history, like of
statistically,
America,
not like reading a history book.
Yes, but just, like, looked at the numbers, even, like, there's one conclusion you can make.
Bad.
Shit was fucked up. No, shit's still fucked up.
Yeah.
Nothing really changed. It's just packaged to us differently. You know, because it's like, oh, communism is bad. And it's like, well, we're going through this Red Scare thing again. We did that already. 1950, McCarthyism. Oh, people don't know about that. I wonder why. Because our textbooks are from 1950.
Some of them are from 1950, but they leave out a lot of very convenient things. Kale and I had a full-on conversation the other day about just, like, events in history that we have learned about in like the last 2 to 3 years that are major fucking events, but we've never heard about them because they were terrible. And not only were they were terrible to non-white people. Events that are terrible to white people are all over the history books.
I would like to say, this is a safe space, yes?
No, but go ahead.
I didn't know about the Korean War until I was 20 years old. It's sitting in a government class. In college, and I was like, the what war? And they were like, yeah, the Korean War. And I was like, oh yeah, I know. And then I had to do some Googling.
Japan tried to take over the world in the 50s, and we just, like, didn't talk about it.
We talk about the fact that the Korean War happened, but actually, the Korean War harbors a lot of Korean hate.
Yeah.
It really wasn't even, like, mostly their deal.
Like, right! You see how fucked up this is?
It's called the Korean War. You see?
It was real
and
fucked
Americans
up.
Died in the Korean War, so Korea bad.
Yeah, yeah, that's how. No. It's like, no. No, like, Japan tried to kill every single Korean person, and America's like, damn, we hate Korea. And it's like, what? Huh? Like, where did you come up with that?
Yeah.
Again,
no, love Pokemon though.
Love Pokemon. Zelda, love it.
Yeah.
Put that shit right in my veins.
Nintendo.
Things are great. Yeah.
So in summary, people in Arkansas can fight. In history, bad.
Terrible. Much worse than you ever imagined.
We just hope you learn something every time you listen to the Salty Virgins Club podcast, and those are your two tidbits for today.
Better or for worse.
America, bad.
Horror.
Historically, Arkansas, good at fighting. Bad, everything else.
Because of American history.
Full circle, baby. Thank you for listening to this week's Salty Virgins Club Pie.
We will see you tonight for Dungeons & Dragons. Love you.
Hey, love kids. You guys.
Peace. Today we're going to learn about the world. The world that's around us is pretty amazing. But how does it work? It must be complicated. The secret is the world can only work when everything works together. A bee drinks from a flower and leaves with its pollen. A squirrel in a tree spreads the seeds that have fallen. Everything works together. The biggest elephant, the littlest fly. The gophers underground, the birds in the sky. And every single cricket, every fish in the sea gives what they can and gets what they need. That is how the world works. That is how the world works. From A to zebra to the worms in the dirt. That's how
everyone. Look who stopped by to say hello. It's Socko.
Hey.
Where you been, Socko?
I've been where I always am when you're not wearing me on your hand. In a frightening liminal space between states of being. Not quite dead, not quite alive. It's similar to a constant state of sleep paralysis.
Socko, we were just talking about the world and how it works.
Boy, that sounds complicated.
Do you have anything you'd want to teach us about the world?
I wouldn't say anything that you probably haven't already said yourself.
I don't know about that, Socko. How about you give it a try?
All right. The simple narrative taught in every history class is demonstrably false and pedagogically classist. Don't you know the world is built with blood and genocide and exploitation? The global network of capital essentially functions to separate the worker from the means of production. And the FBI killed Martin Luther King. Private property's inherently theft. And neoliberal fascists are destroying the left. And every politician, every cop on the street protects the interests of the pedophilic corporate elite. That is how the world works.
Really?
That is how the world works. Genocide the natives, say you got to it first. That's how it works.
That's pretty intense.
No shit.
What can I do to help?
Read a book or something, I don't know. Just don't burden me with the responsibility of educating you. It's incredibly exhausting.
I'm sorry, Socko. I was just trying to become a better person.
Why do you rich fucking white people insist on seeing every socio-political conflict through the myopic lens of your own self-actualization? This isn't about you, so either get with it or get out of the fucking way.
Watch your mouth, buddy. Remember who's on whose hand here.
But that's what I've... Have you not been fucking listening? We are entrenched
all right,
in a...
Wait,
no, please, I don't want to go back. I can't go back, please. Please. I'm sorry.
Are you going to behave yourself?
Yes.
Yes. What?
Yes, sir.
Look at me.
Yes, sir.
That's better.
That is how the world works. That is how the world works.
I hope you learned your lesson.
I did and it hurt. That's how it works.